Hi, welcome to Guitar Interactive magazine. I'm Stuart Shields and I am here today with the Line 6 Helix, much coveted and much sought after. Lots of information about this online and there is a lot to go into. This isn't going to be a tutorial, we're just going to do a quick overview of some of the basic functions of this so you can get a better insight into how this works. Now, at a glance, this is a modeler. It's a modeler and effects processor. Loaded with DSP, HD amp models. Within this, there are 62 amps that are being modeled. We have 104 pedals currently and 37 speaker emulations and scenarios that we have. Now, what makes this different, and it almost seems like everyone and their uncle is producing a modeler or a profiler. The thing that makes the Helix a little bit different, and we'll talk about this in a moment, is the virtual circuitry modeling. So what I mean by that is the depth and the level and the detail that has gone into producing these models. Now, virtual circuitry modeling is a bit of technology that really exists in the sound engineering world. And it really means that we're trying to produce software versions of the hardware itself. So every circuit, every little algorithm of the amps and the pedals is being recreated here. And it really is very natural, very responsive. The detail, again, is incredible. Even that first signal path from the input through to the first tube, things like the power supply, the effects that that has on the hum, the sag, the tube bias, all of these little nuances have really been very, very detailed and very well modeled. So the end result is each amp model really does sound, and I think the word I'm looking for here is behaves like that amp, that pedal should and does. So having a look just basically at the build of this, the first thing that's quite striking about this is just this real robust, solid look to it. It kind of looks a little bit like Batman's pedal board would, which is quite cool. Very sleek, very dark, very cool. Its operation is very kind of robust and reassuringly solid. And we have this nice big chunky, clunky effect pedal, expression pedal on the back. All of the controls, again, are really high quality. And it looks very much like the dashboard of like an executive car would. Really kind of smacks of quality. So the thing to look for really with this that makes this great is it's so intuitive. What we have at the top here is we have a main screen and I've got a preset already loaded in here. Like a lot of the Line 6 products, it really promises that you don't have to have a manual to feel your way around this. This is all very intuitive and it works much like the way that we think as guitar players. That you have a signal path, you have an effects chain where your pedals and your amps sit. So this is really, really easy. If I just go into a blank patch here, a new preset like this, we have a completely blank screen here, nothing going on at all. And what we've got represented here are just two signal paths that I can really put anything in that I like. Now, the best thing about this is that we have this massive bank of amps and pedals. And when we're loading up stuff, it really does feel like we're going shopping. So if we just hit the main menu, and what comes up is just effectively a shopping list. So if we scroll down, and I want to have an amp. So let's just go with an amp all on its own. We go to guitar like this, as you can see. Click this in and we have this massive list of these HD model amps that we can pick from. Now I'm going to go down to something very safe and let's find ourselves a Plexi. So there we go, Brit Plexi Bright. Here we go. And what we have now within there is an amp block and it should sound like this. It's not going to sound very inspiring, it's going to sound a little bit dead. And the reason is, what we need with this, is we need a cab. So, click on this again, flick down, and we can select a cab from our list. We've got a Plexi, let's go for a 4x12. So here we have, we'll just pick one at random. Bring back 24 by 12, do this, and this should sound a little better. And there we go, comes to life, sounds more like an amped up scenario. Within this cab, this is quite cool. Now, normally when you go to a gig, you would have your amp, your cab, you would really just use like a 57, a dynamic mic. You're not gonna take expensive microphones like condenser mics or ribbon mics around with you to gigs. What the Helix does that's quite cool is we can actually change, if you can see on this main screen here, we can change the mic itself. So I can scroll through a selection of dynamic ribbon and condenser mics. Let's just go for a ribbon mic, something kind of nice and bottom endy. Again, we've just got an amp block and a cab. Let's have something more in our chain. Let's keep going. And next in line, well, we need some pedals because this sounds quite dry. So if I scoot down, see I've selected reverb, click this, on comes our selection of reverbs, click on it, and appears, like magic, a reverb pedal, which is quite cool. Now we should have some reverb. Now, this is now just simply in this little interface here, but if I click this button, just at the touch, assign to foot switch, do that again, and we click OK, and now my reverb is here. I can control it from the floorboard. So, and off. Back on. And of course, just at the touch of this, it brings up the pedal and we can change any of those parameters from the reverb that we like. If we keep going, I can work a signal path based on what I want. And again, I can just go shopping. We can have a delay. Bring in simple delay like this, and up pops our delay. Same thing again. I can touch the button that I want to assign the delay to, press OK, and there's my delay. On. And off. So rather than build a massive signal path here, this isn't really a tutorial, I thought it'd be quite cool just to show you the basic functions of this. What I find quite nice and reassuring about the Helix is that it has in mind the gigging guitarist. So you notice that when we've assigned things to pedals like this, the delay and the reverb, they appear on scribble strips instantly, which is very, very cool. We can rename these whatever we want. This could be big reverb, this could be crazy delay, whatever you want. But they're colored as well. And I know you can't really see this with the studio lights, but in a dark room, these really jump out. So when you're gigging and performing, these are the reassuring colors that you know that represent the effect. So for me, delay is always green, chorus is always blue, reverb is orange, and distortion is yellow. And these kind of match the pedals that I grew up with. So it's very intuitive. It's very much something that you're already, a language you already know how to speak, as it were. So yeah, the controls are very, very well lit, very easy to see in a gig situation. A testament to that is really this huge tuner that we have as well, this massive tuner, which you can see from space. I mean, this is gigantic. So anywhere you are on the stage, you can see this. So I think the idea behind a lot of these little intricate designs is it's very much for the musician on the road. Building these patches is really easy. Again, if you want to move any of these blocks, you can click action, and that block can move up and down or into a new signal path. For example, if we've got a delay that's really getting in the way of stuff, we can actually move it down. And suddenly it's on another signal chain and it stays out of the way of our main path. Now, going back to this, what we can also do that's quite cool with the Helix is, say I've picked an amp that I like the Plexi, I've got a good cab that I like, I've got the pedals that I want, I can simply do this. I can set up four different versions of that amp. It's what they call a snapshot. A snapshot is really simply just that, it's a photograph of those settings. So if I go into my amp and I've picked a Plexi, like the sound of this, but I would like snapshot one to be a bit cleaner. Press down on the button, turn the drive right down, and you see it's highlighted there. We should have now a version which is nice and clean. If I go to my second snapshot, I can change this again. I can bring the drive back up. I can alter any of these parameters here on the EQ, for example, or I can bring my delay in. I don't want so much delay, so I can click on this and I can take the mix right down, but maybe just for this patch. So I click on it, turn it down, and we take the mix right down. Snapshot three, if I click on this, what we can also do now is just make things a bit more lively. I can bring the drive back up. I can even assign another pedal if I wanted to. If I wanted to have a distortion pedal here, we can do just that very quickly. And we should now have a distortion pedal in the mix. Touch this, click OK, and there's my distortion pedal. So now I have a snapshot, the separate distortion on. And I can turn this on, turn this off if I want. When I go back to snapshot two, distortion pedal's gone. Snapshot three, it's back on. Now, where it is at the moment sounds a little bit overpowering. So, simple as this. I've got my distortion pedal selected. I go to action. I can drag this. And if I like, I can put this before the amp. And it sounds a bit more natural. So any of these pedals, any of these blocks can be moved around the chain, which is quite cool because this really does feel like the pedal board that you know and love. So if you're a digital cynic and you really love just an amp and a pedal board and keeping things simple, this is going to speak to you. There are no crazy menus to look at. Line 6 profess that you don't even have to read the manual to get used to this bit of kit. And I definitely agree. It's very intuitive, very easy to use. And it's all right there in front of you with this signal path. As I say, there's no long-winded menus and crazy interfaces that you have to use. Very, very easy to use, very intuitive. And again, when you get a sound that you like, quite easy to dial in, you can have four different versions of that within the same bank. So as promised, this is just a quick overview of what the Helix can do. We could really talk for hours about this and its operation. One more thing to mention is that there is lots of routing options with the Helix. We do have another 4 effects loops in here. So this isn't really there to replace what you already use and run. All your favorite pedals can be integrated with the Helix, and we can even actually assign them to the foot switches, as we did with the virtual pedals as well. We can run this direct into a PA as well, so this can be your one-stop shop. You don't have to have an external cab with this. With this, we are actually going direct into a desk at the moment. So that is the Helix. As always, check out the magazine for more details. I'll see you next time.